Hi, this is Ultra Hillier. When I was 14 years old, I came up with a Zelda theory that Princess Zelda in Spirit Tracks was dead and that Link was basically insane. And, well, since then, I've come up with some more ideas on this, some supporting material, and I'm going to talk about it today. Before I begin, just a bit of a warning that this theory does include mentions of a character dying, character being insane, and several characters not existing. It's nothing too traumatic, but important to keep in mind if you have attachments to this game. So the original theory I had was that Link and Zelda were in love, and after Zelda died, Link started to blame everything on Chancellor Cole, and that basically led to him having these delusions that Zelda's ghost was following him, which wasn't happening because nobody else in the game can see that. And well, it's true. Link and Zelda were definitely in love. You can see that in the game's intro, really. I'm going to be talking a bit more about this. So the game gets off to a seemingly innocent start with Link meeting Zelda for the first time. It talks a bit about legends and spirits, but it's sort of relatively realistic. And then we have the scene where Link is taking Zelda to the Tower of Spirits, and the spirit tracks disappear and they get ambushed by Chancellor Cole, and Zelda's spirit gets separated from her body. Now, what I believe really happened in this scene was that there was a train accident and Zelda died in the train accident, and I don't think anything else actually happened. And what I think this scene is, when Link is driving the train, after him and Zelda get in the train, there's no controls on screen at all. The game sort of automatically takes you on a rail for like a few minutes. And obviously this was done for gameplay purposes, so the player doesn't just disappear. But this is the only time in the game that ever happens. And I think basically what this represents is this isn't something that Link had control over. It was actually a dream in which he imagined all the stuff happening. So train accident happens, Zelda dies, and then he has this traumatic flashback dream with all the tracks disappearing and Chancellor Cole being behind it all. And that's basically what sets off his schizophrenia, basically. And I think the first thing to point out about this scene is Chancellor Cole's character design is very unrealistic. Now, I know this is a fantasy game and all that, but it's a bit strange that he has two demonic horns hiding under his top hat. Like, it seems like the sort of thing that a young child would sort of imagine, like someone they strongly dislike as a way of like demonizing them effectively. And Link is a child in this game, so it seems that it only makes sense that he would imagine something as imaginative as this. It's also important to note that prior to this point in the game, Chancellor Cole is only seen in Hyrule Castle. However, in this dream sequence, he is seen arriving on the demon train, which sort of comes up this portal from another dimension. So it seems very far-fetched that he would, sort of in a short space of time, travel to the Dark Realm and then back just to confront Link and Zelda. And whilst we're talking about this, the demon train looks very similar to Wario, all characters. It's very childlike again, so it's not too displausible to say that Link is again imagining all of this happening, and he imagined and made out the design of the demon train for whatever reason. What's more important to note is that the Chancellor's personality changes quite a bit here. Prior to this part of the game, the Chancellor is definitely very subtly suspicious. He makes a few evil smirks, a couple of snappy moments, and he makes an odd comment about Link's train becoming useless. However, it doesn't necessarily mean in the context of the spirit tracks disappearing. Although, after this point of the game, he completely changes. The once well-controlled man, who was occasionally slightly sinister, becomes completely unstable and basically stays this way for the rest of the game. He does say that the Chancellor thing was just an act, however it seems odd that he would expose himself to Link, Zelda and Alfonso, and all he really does is insult the three of them and steal Zelda's body. If all he needed to do was steal Zelda's body, then he could have done so in a much more private manner. I mean, he's basically always at Hyrule Castle. It just doesn't make sense that he would idiotically expose himself to both Link and Alfonso, and then on top of that, to have such a sudden personality change. And the reason for this, I believe, is because that this isn't the real Chancellor Cole. This is the imagined version that Link believes is the problem. And the reason why Link thinks Chancellor Cole is the problem? Well, to be honest, it basically comes down to his previously slightly sinister behaviour. And it's due to the fact that Link has trauma. He greatly exaggerates this behaviour. The only other thing not discussed is the fact that Cole wears two top hats, which is a bit odd. It's not that unusual. Right? Anyway, so after this scene, we're introduced to Spirit Zelda, who is floating around Hyrule Castle trying to talk to people, but nobody can see or hear her, except for Link. For some reason, he's the only person. And this pattern is prominent throughout the entire game. We never see anyone else who can talk to Zelda. And I simply believe that's because she isn't there. It's all Link's delusions. Now, I technically did lie just that second, because Anne Jean and the other Locomotos, who are basically the spirits of this game, they can see Zelda. And the canonical explanation is because all their spirits, they can see other spirits. But realistically, we don't see any of these locomotives until after this happens, after Spirit Zelda is introduced, after the whole weird dream sequence. So, would it be too much of a stretch to say the locomotives don't exist either? I mean, seriously, think about it. And Jean is always at the bottom of the tower with the spirits, just waiting there. She's supposed to be like a guardian spirit, but anybody could just walk into the tower of spirits and she'd just be there. It seems a bit odd that she would be somewhere a bit more protected. I personally believe that Link also created Anne Jean and the locomotives, and he did this specifically to justify his pointless adventures and his delusions, to give him more of a reason to believe that it is legitimately Zelda's ghost following him around, talking to him. It's not, but these locomotives that he thinks are there are telling him that Zelda's going around following him as a ghost, and that he needs to do these things, so it justifies his actions in doing so, and it makes him think he's not crazy. And this brings me on to the slightly philosophical part, which is that, to be honest, Maladus, as a character, is the representation of Link's schizophrenia. It might sound odd, but just hear me out on this. Cole steals Zelda's body so that he can resurrect Maladus. Maladus possesses Zelda's body, so in other words, Link's schizophrenia mainly manifests itself in Zelda's spirit following him around, and Maladus manifests itself in possessing Zelda. Cole is controlling Maladus, but he's also controlling Link's schizophrenia, if that makes sense. Everything we see about Maladus is basically Link's schizophrenia. Now, at the end of the game, there's a scene in which, after Maladus is freed from Zelda's body, he takes control of Chancellor Cole. And this scene is basically representing Link's mental state slipping into the worst it's been throughout the entire game. And Link now feels that it's directly Cole attacking him, Zelda is no longer the center of his schizophrenia, it's now Cole. The Zelda schizophrenia is still there a little bit, but it's no longer her ghost following him around. It's now what he thinks is a physical being, helping him to defeat and overcome Cole slash Maladus, i.e. his schizophrenia. So, the main question now is how come, at the end of the game, Link still sees Zelda, even though his schizophrenia is all gone? Well, the answer for that is a little bit depressing. Basically, Link's dead. The only way for him to get over his schizophrenia was for him to die, either accidentally or via suicide. And once Cole slash Maladus is defeated, he's no longer imagining this physical being Zelda. He's actually in heaven with her. And that basically sums up my theory. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you've got any questions or ideas, please leave them in the comments. If you're interested in shitposts, I regularly make Google Translated videos and a few Nintendo memes and bits like that if you want to subscribe. You're not missing out on much. Enjoy whatever it is you're doing with your day.